Our life becomes auspicious when we harbor sublime thoughts. The thoughts become noble and uplifted when the mind is purified. And the mind is cleansed by attaching it in loving devotion to the all-pure Supreme. So love for God is absolutely the most auspicious activity we can engage in for ourselves and for the whole world. This love requires cultivation of divine sentiments. You could do that towards a deity. There's a very popular story from North India. There was an illiterate person called Dhanna Jat. He used to go and help in a temple on a daily basis. He was growing old. He said to Panditji, that Panditji, please teach me some bhakti. Panditji said, what bhakti will you do? You don't know any Ved mantras. No, it's only a few days of my life left now. You must teach me some devotion. Panditji took a stone grinder and gave it to him. He said, what is this? Panditji said, it's a shaligram of the Lord. You do its bhakti. How will I do it? What will you do? Every day you get up, you bathe the Lord and do the Shringar, and whatever you eat, you offer to the Lord as well. So Dhanna Jat went home with a piece of stone, very happy. Bhagavan has come to my house today. At night, he put Bhagavan by his side and went off to sleep. Next morning, he bathed that stone. He did the Shringar, the Tilak with the Chandan. Since he was a poor man, he used to eat two rotis. He placed one before that stone and said, O Bhagavan, please eat. What will the stone eat? He thought, maybe God is a little more hungry. All right, take my roti as well. Still he is not eating. Dhanna Jat said, maybe his mood has got off. I got him deliberately from Panditji's place. All right, Bhagavan, if you don't eat, I will also not eat. He sat down there doing anshan fasting. One day went by, 2 days went by, 7 days went by. Now God has a weakness. You know, in business, people try and find the other's weakness and then exploit it. So what is the weakness of God? He has a very soft heart. Wherever he sees true love, he melts. So he saw that this devotee has created divine sentiments in a piece of stone, thinking it to be Lord Krishna, and has not eaten for 7 days. The Lord melted. He manifested from that stone itself. This is a very famous story of North India, of Dhanna Jat. The Lord manifested and started eating. Dhanna thought, lo, he has become God with hands and feet. The Lord finished one roti and then put his hand forward to the second roti. Dhanna held it. He said, listen, you have been hungry since 7 days. I have also been hungry. Now let me eat my roti. This jhapta jhapti began. And Finally, God said, "Are Dhanna, what will you eat? One roti." He put his hand on his head and blessed him. Dhanna Jat was revealed the knowledge of all the Vedic scriptures, and he received the divine love in his heart. Now look, he purified himself by creating divine sentiments, even though it was towards a piece of stone. That doesn't matter. God is sitting in the heart. He knows what we are thinking and rewards accordingly. Dhanna succeeded like this. We people find difficulty in creating divine sentiments towards our Ishtadev, the worshipable Supreme Divine Lord Sri Krishna. And why does this lack or deficiency happen? Because we don't have enough faith. And why is there a lack of faith? Because of insufficient understanding. That is why, if we wish to develop love for God, we must strive to understand His divine entity. Not on the basis of intellect alone, but through the medium of the Guru and the scriptures. So yesterday, I had mentioned to you, in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna said, "Janma karma cha me divyam evam yo veti tatvatah tyaktva deham punar janma naiti mameti surjuna." O Arjun, one who understands the divine secret of my birth and my works, then doesn't keep a material intellect towards me. That soul is easily able to cultivate divine sentiments and thereby achieve love for me to cross over the ocean of life and death. So we had discussed the birth of the Lord is divine. When Lord Krishna manifested in the prison house of Kans in Mathura, he did not manifest as a little baby. Tamadbhutam balakam ambujekshanam chaturbhujam shankha gadayudayudham. The Bhagavatam states that he manifested a 6-foot form. In his hand he was holding the Shankh Chakra Gada Padma, the Sudarshan disc. Now that 6-foot form, could it have emerged from the womb of Devaki? The disc in the Lord's hand is the sharpest thing in the world. Imagine the discomfort of Devaki if the Lord had sat down like that in her stomach. So it was a divine birth by his yoga maya. He made the mother feel that the child is in the womb. But then at the appropriate moment, the womb emptied and the Lord manifested in front. This is the difference between our birth and the divine birth of the Lord. We also discussed that the Lord's form is also divine. We have the deh. The Sanskrit word for the body is deh. And we are the dehi, those who reside in this body. There is a distinction, deh and dehi. This distinction does not exist for God. Deha dehi bhidhas chaiva nanyas chaiva kadachana, Narad Puran. Deha dehi vibhedoyam neshvare vidyate kachit. Ved Vyas has written in the Varaha Puran, the Lord himself becomes his body. So this body of the Lord is very miraculous. When we see it, everybody perceives it to the limit of their spiritual power. Like, for example, in the Krishna Leela, Lord Krishna resided in Vrindavan for 11 years and 52 days. And then he went to Mathura. There, Kans had arranged for a Dhanur Yajna, the bow sacrifice. And Lord Krishna, he entered the Rangshala stadium where the band was going on. It was a carnival kind of festival. And as he entered, everybody saw Krishna differently. The Bhagavatam states, Mallanam Mashanirninam Naravarastrinam Smaro Murtiman Gopanam Swajano Satang Sitibhujang Shasta Swapitro Shishu Mrityur Bhojapate Virat Vidusham Tatvam Param Yoginam Vrishninam Paradevateti Vidito Rangangata Sagrajah. First of all, Kans, he sent forth his wrestlers, Chanur and Mushtik. You may have seen in the Krishna serial, huge personalities. So they looked at Krishna and said, this puny little guy, we'll squash him and make chutney of him with our hands. They could bend iron. But before wrestling, the wrestlers, they shake hands. And while doing so, Lord Krishna, he bent the little finger of his hand. Now the wrestlers put all their might, but they could not straighten it. So they say, Mallana Mashanir Ninam Naravara. He seems as hard as a thunderbolt. And the ladies there, who had been hearing the glories of Lord Krishna and secretly worshipping him and been yearning for his darshan, finally they feasted their eyes on his enchanting form and said, wow, he is the most handsome personality in the world. We heard there is one Kamdev Cupid, but he is way beyond. Out there was also Nand Baba, who had come. He said, he is my little child. He was looking with paternal affection. On the other hand, Kans was sitting in the most important VIP place. He looked and thought, my death personified is dancing. Kans had been told by Narad that this one boy, he will not leave you. So when Kans got the news that Krishna has come, he was petrified. Water has come, he's thinking Krishna may be in it, throw it away. Food has come, he is doubting, oh, this black colored dal may be Krishna, discard it. He's seeing Krishna in his clothes and ripping them. Asina samvishan tishthan bhunjana paryatan mahim chintayano rishikesha mapashyat tanmayan jagat. And the associate evil kings of Kans, they were looking and getting terrified, like a junior clerk is terrified by the company director. So everybody is looking at Krishna differently. This is the miracle of the divine form of God. Hence, if we just see God, don't think you will become God realized. Sometimes people ask the question, Swamiji, can we see God? But do you know, it's highly likely that in our endless past lifetimes, we have possibly seen God. The Hindu philosophy is not a one lifetime. We all are eternal souls and we've had innumerable past lives. So 5,000 years ago when Lord Krishna descended, it is possible we were here. It is possible we also saw him. But we could not recognize his divinity because our senses were material. Hence the Bhagavad Gita says, avajananti mamudha manushim tanumashritam parambhavamajananto mamabhutamaheshwaram. Arjun, Lord Krishna says, when I descend on this planet Earth, the materially conditioned souls are unable to perceive my divine personality because they don't have the purified senses. So let us not get into this misconception that if I could just see God, I'd become God realized. Take the case of Duryodhan. Duryodhan, when he was in Hastinapur and the war of Mahabharata was becoming imminent, Lord Krishna thought that let me, for the sake of the world, strive for a compromise formula so that in future people don't blame me that Krishna was present on the planet, then why did the Mahabharata happen? So Krishna said, let me show them. He went for the sandhi, for some kind of agreement, to Hastinapur. And he said to Duryodhan, the Pandavas are your cousin brothers. Duryodhan said, absolutely, Keshav. They have the right to live. Definitely, Keshav. They are princes. To live, they need some amount of land. Yes, Shyam Sundar. Give them 5 villages. There will be no war. Declared. Duryodhan said, 5 villages. Suchakam naiva dasyami bina yuddhena Keshava. I will not concede to them the amount of land that could come on the tip of a needle. Shri Krishna said, now what to do with this guy? He showed his virat roop, the cosmic form. The same form that he will show subsequently to Arjun in the Bhagavad Gita. But Arjun, looking at it, said, Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram Paramam Bhavan, Purusham Shashvadam Divyam Adi Devam Ajam Vibhum. Duryodhan said nothing of the sort. He said, who is this joker? What kind of magic is he doing? Tie him up with a rope and throw him into the cellar. See, Duryodhan had darshan, but not attainment. So there's a difference. We all likely in endless lifetimes during the avatar have probably seen Ram, Krishna, etc. But our purpose will be served when we attain God. And we will attain him when we receive his grace. Hence in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Tat prasadat param shantim sthanam prapsyasi shashvatam. Arjun, by his prasad, by his grace, you will reach the Lord. And to receive his grace, we will have to surrender to him. We will have to purify the mind through loving devotion, through nishkam bhakti. That is why it is of critical importance to all of us to understand the rahasya, the secret of Lord Krishna's descension, so that we don't use our buddhi. We engage in devotion with staunch faith and succeed in cultivating the positive sentiments that will purify us. So, having understood that the birth of God is divine, his form is also divine. Now let's understand, why does he descend at all? He is not calling us to his divine abode. And whenever he likes, he is coming here. What is the purpose of it? In relation to the avatar, there are a couple of shlokas in the Bhagavad Gita that everybody has heard of. Yada yada dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srijamyam paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma sansthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. The Lord here in these two verses explains, O Arjun, when there is a rise in adharma and a decline in dharma, at that time I descend to establish the principles of religiosity. First reason. Second reason, I descend to kill the demons. And the third reason, I descend to protect my devotees. Good, that seems to make sense. But when we ponder over it, we will find that these three reasons may be right, but they are not the most important reasons. You see, God is Sarvagya, all-knowing. He accomplishes a lot of works at the same time. Ram Janma Ke Hetu Aneka Param Vichitra Ekate Eka. Just like there was once a Sethji, a business person. He had a Munim, a secretary, and a clerk, Pappu. So the secretary would get 50,000 rupees a month, and Pappu would get 10,000 rupees a month. The secretary Munimji would be sitting on a wonderful cushioned sofa in the office in air condition, offering juice to clients and taking for himself. And poor Pappu would be running up and down in the market all day to do the assigned works. So one day, Pappu brought up his grudge to Sethji and said, Sethji, I run from morning till night and I am given only 10,000 rupees a month salary. And Munimji, he sits here in air conditioned and he earns 50,000. Why do you give him 50,000? Sethji thought, let me open his eyes. So the next day he said, Pappu, my daughter-in-law has had a child. The doctor has said, feed him bakri, goat's milk. It is very healthy. Just go and find out, is there a goat anywhere? Pappu said, Sethji, I'll go and come in a jiffy. He went off, is there a goat? Do you have a goat? Do you have a goat? Ah, yes. He came back and said, Sethji, I have located in that particular house, they do have a goat. Sethji said, does she give milk? Oh, Sethji, I forgot to ask. Just hold on, I will find out. He ran off and asked, does your goat give milk? They said, yes. So he returned and said, Sethji, she does give milk. Acha? How much milk does she give? Sethji, I forgot to ask that question. He again ran off, found out it delivers 1 kg of milk every day. So Sethji said, will they sell it? Sethji, you know, that I have not asked. So go and ask. He came and said, will you be willing to sell your goat? So this running up and down happened all day long. The next day, Sethji said, Munimji, my daughter-in-law needs goat's milk for her newborn child. Please, go and find out and make arrangements. Munimji searched around. He found the most appropriate goat, purchased it, brought it, and handed it to Sethji. "Here is the goat, Sethji. Give milk to your grandchild." Sethji said, "Pappu, look, you spent the whole day and the work was not done." Munimji has got the buddhi, intellect. He did it all in one shot. That is why he is paid his salary. So God is Sarvagya. When he descends as an avatar, he accomplishes innumerable things. And these three, which were mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, are incidental. The real reason is something else. Why are they incidental? Because you say that Lord Krishna descended to establish dharma. Well, dharma can be established by saints as well. Shankaracharya did it, Madhavacharya, Nimbarkacharya. And dharma is sanatan, eternal. God only kills the demons and protects the devotees. Dharma becomes re-established. Besides, if you say Lord Krishna descended to establish dharma, when he wound up and closed his pastimes, Kalyug started. Where was the dharma established? This reason doesn't seem to predominate. Take the second one. The Lord descended to kill the demons. So, who were these demons? They were saints from Golok, the divine abode, Jay and Vijay, who had descended as Sishupal and Dantavakra, as Ravan and Kumbhakarn, as Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. They had been sent by the Lord to participate in his pastimes, to thicken the plot. And if he needed just to kill a demon, he doesn't have to come down and then kill with his weapon. All he needs is to generate a virus that is 10 times more powerful than the Ebola virus. And what to speak of Ravan, none of his doctors will know what has happened to him. You see, God is Satya Sankalp, Sankalpa Devasya Pitara Samuttishthanti. He only thinks and the work is done. That God descends and then strikes up a fight with Ravan and then says, "He is not dying, Vibhishan, please tell me how to kill him." And Vibhishan says, "My Lord, I will tell you. This is only a drama. This is only an act. Hence, the reason of descending to kill demons also does not jive as the paramount one. The third one, to protect the devotees." Now tell me, did God become a bodyguard of the devotees? Of course not. He is protecting his devotees from inside. Ye yatha mam prapadyante tans tathaiva bhajamyaham. He says, if you surrender to me, I shall maintain your yogakshem. Tesham nityabhyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyaham. Yogakshem means he will protect us like the mother protects the child. So, none of these, they are all right, they are fine. But the real reason for the avatar is something even deeper. And this is revealed by Vedavyas in the Bhagavatam. Anugrahaya bhutanam manusham dehamasthitah bhajate tadrishi kridaya shrutva tatparo bhavet. The Lord descends to grace and bless the souls. How will they be blessed when they have auspicious thoughts? How will they have auspicious thoughts when their mind is purified? How will the mind get cleansed By engaging in devotion. How will they engage in bhakti? They need a form to attach their mind to, a name to take, leelas to remember and contemplate upon. Because the formless is inconceivable, intangible, extremely difficult to worship. So when he descended in that form, he gave the basis for bhakti to billions upon billions of souls who were to come in the future. Today we say Radhe Govind, Radhe Shyam. If Govind had not manifested, how would we take advantage of these different avenues for devotion? So his primary purpose was to bless. Because he has no need of anything for himself. He is perfect and complete. See, we are not perfect and not complete. Because we want bliss. We are little parts of the ocean of bliss. It is our intrinsic nature to keep striving to get the bliss we need, and we cannot remain still until we get it. So if we help somebody, it will not be causeless, it will not be ahaituki, it will be sahaituki. There will be a self-interest. I'll help you because I will get this. And the Lord has no need. Atma prayojana bhave paranugraha evahi. He is an ocean of bliss. Bliss is an aspect of him. So if either he should do nothing, or if ever he does anything, there is only one reason for it: to bestow blessings upon the souls. Jagata mupakaraya Vishnu Puran. Mukhyam tasya hi karunyam. Maharshi Shandilya has said in his Bhakti Darshan, to grace the souls. Jagadguru Sri Kripaluji Maharaj says, Karana Hari Avatar Ko Kripa Akarana Jana Aparajite Karana Kahe Tinahi Gaun Kariman. The main reason was Akaran Kripa. So in the pastimes that Lord Krishna performed was a treasure chest of bhakti. But the key to it was locked. The saints who came in this age of Kali, one after the other after the other, they took the key and opened the treasure chest. And they took out the bhakti from there and distributed to the souls. Look, you have a bonanza of Krishna bhakti that is possible in this age of Kali. So what is that bonanza then? Let's discuss. See, Aishwarya Shravanad Bhakti Rutpanna Pinavardhate Bina Gunanusangatmad Bhagavat Pad Padmayo. If you wish to love God, you need to feel that connection. He is mine. If all we can think of, he is great, he is almighty, we will be fearful, we will be reverential, but that intimate sentiment of love will not get enhanced. Like in the world, a lady, her husband may be the general in the army to whom 10,000, 100,000 people salute. But that wife, she only thinks he is my husband. That is how she loves him. She puts the Aishwarya aside. Similarly, to love God, don't just think he is God, he is God, he is God. Otherwise, you will experience fear. There are loving relationships that you can establish with him. He is God, no doubt, but he has a law of love. Ye yatha mam prapadyante tans tathaiva bhajami. He says, as you love me, I will reciprocate accordingly. If the devotee thinks, oh Krishna, you are my friend, come here, I'll put my arm around you. Krishna says, Arjun, you are my bosom buddy, come on. If the devotee says, oh Krishna, look, I will take care of you. That is my seva bhav, my sentiment. You don't need to think about me. Krishna says, Yashoda, I am putting myself at your disposal. Now you are my mother, I am all yours. So Yashoda is the mother of God. And if the devotee says, oh Krishna, I know no other apart from you, you are my sole beloved. Krishna says, oh Gopi, I am willing to be your sole beloved. So these are the leelas that Krishna displayed that give us all hope. Yes, he is God, yet I can look on him as my very own. This is the specialty of our Sanatan Vaidic Dharma, which we call Hinduism. You know, devotion to God is taught around the world, often with the predominant sentiment of fear. Ya ayyuhu allazeen amanutta kulla wa kunu in Allah azijun hakeemun. ईमान वालों, अल्लाह मिया खुदावन ताला निहायत दंड देने वाला है. He is very annoyed and he punishes extremely. You need to follow him. That is all very well, but there is a loving aspect of God and he subjugates himself. This the Vedas tell us, that the highest quality of God is bhaktvatsal, lover of his devotees. No, even higher. Bhaktavashya, he is enslaved by his devotees. Look, Krishna was a 4-year-old in his leela, and he is taken avatar and is doing his pastimes in an agrarian setting where people live off the land. So one gopi was working in the field. There was a pile of cow dung and she needed to move it. When Kanhaiya came and stood there, the gopi saw and said, Shyam Sundar, help me out. Fill the basket with this gober and give it to me. I'll give you a ball of butter. Krishna said, really? Food for work? Okay. He started filling it up. He loves butter. So he took it and gave it to the gopi. The gopi said, the whole pile needs to be lifted. Just keep filling the baskets and handing them to me. I'll give you one ball of butter for every basket that you work for me. Krishna said, all right, you got a deal there. Contract signed. He started filling and handing over the baskets. But after 3 or 4, he lost count. Bhondu what? So he said, who will keep track? Gopi said, that is the least of problems. We'll convert your cheek into an account book. Every time you hand the basket to me, I'll take one bindi of gober and I'll stick it to your cheek. Later on, we'll count how many do you have. Krishna said, you are brilliant. So he got to work in right earnest. One cheek was filled, the other was filled, the forehead was also filled. So Gomaya Mandita Bhala Kapolam. That Lord who's worshipped by the Vedas. Sahasra Shirekha Purukha Sahasraksha Sahasra Pata Sabhumigvam Sarvatas Pritvatyatishtadashangulam. The same Lord's face has been covered by cow dung. How is this happening? In her love, the gopi has forgotten that he is God. There is the love energy and the knowledge energy, the Gyan Shakti and the Prema Shakti. When the love swells, the knowledge immerses in it. The devotee forgets this is God. Otherwise, the fear will take over, and God also forgets that he is God. That is when the loving exchanges take place. So Krishna said, you know, it's been a lot of hard work. I have toiled it out. Now give me the butter. Gopi said, what butter? What butter? It was our contract. How many baskets I lift? You give me that much of butter. Are Baba, butter is not here. It is at home. Come. Now she is walking along with Krishna. She is getting the sanidhya, the closeness of Krishna, and she is delighted. Out there at home, there was another gopi sitting. And she looked at Krishna's face and pointed and said, Ari Sakhi, what have you done to him? So they both broke into laughter. Krishna said, why are you laughing? Go and look at your face. Krishna went and looked at his face in the mirror. Oh my God, what have you done? He went, took a piece of wet rag, wiped his face clean and came, said, enough is enough. Give me the butter now. The gopi said, what butter are you talking about? What butter you keep forgetting? Our deal was, as many baskets I lift, I'll get that much of butter. The gopi said, look at the deal again. The contract was, as many bindis are there on your face, you will get those many balls of butter. You have cleaned up the whole account book. You'll get nothing. So Krishna was about to cry. When a child begins to cry, he gives a forewarning. The chin goes up and down a few times. Then, bah! In Hindi, it is said, mukh me bedur banna. When this mudra got created of Krishna, the gopi said, all right, don't cry. We'll give you the butter. Take how much you like. These are the loving pastimes of the Lord that give us confidence in our bhakti, that he is the master of the universe, but he is the God of love. And we can relate to him, we can connect with him. How will that connection get created? When we decide that he is mine. This human intellect is such, the moment you decide somebody is mine, the love automatically grows within. One boy and one girl, they don't know each other. It's an arranged marriage. But they take the seven circles around the fire, they say the mantras, and the girl is already falling in love. She is sitting in the veil and thinking, this man to my right is so nice. He fallen in love? Yes, he is my husband. He will take care of me. He will protect me. The sentiment, he is mine, is the foundation of love. The same in the divine realm. Decide, Shri Krishna is mine. How do we look on him as mine? These are the sentiments. The first one, he is my master and I am his servant. There's another one also. He is the king and I am the subject. Now this sentiment is all pervasive around the world, but our Vedas go higher and higher and higher. So he is the king and I am the subject. It's a distant relationship. Someday the king comes and I will go, there goes the king. Can I go and sit at his feet and press his feet and serve him? Hey, the public doesn't have that right. Just see him from far and rejoice. But The higher sentiment is of the servant. Now, majjanmana phalamidam madhukaita bhare mat prarthaniya madanugraha esha eva twat bhritya bhritya parichāraka bhritya bhritya bhrityasya bhritya itimam smaralokanatha. My Lord, I shall consider my life successful if I become the servant of the servant of your servant's servant. To be the servant of the Lord, he is such a master that he feels indebted to his servant. Rama sada sevak ruchi rakhi, ved purana sadhu sagar sakhi. So become the servant of the Lord. But service can take on higher forms. See, people get more happiness from their friend than they get from the servant. The friend is giving happiness, is serving, but at a higher level. So look at the happiness Krishna gets from his friends. Sudama. Sudama was Krishna's classmate. And he knew Krishna is God. That is why Sudama said to Krishna, Yasya chandomayam brahma deha avapanam vibho shreyasam tasya gurushu vasotyanta vidambanam. O Krishna, you have manifested the Vedas. They are your literary incarnation. And that Lord yourself, you have come to Sandipani Muni's ashram to study. This is only your divine pastime. But in that pastime, what happens? When Sudama, he had got separated from Krishna for years, and finally when he went to meet him, and he arrived at the palace, Krishna came running. He held the hand of his sakha and escorted him up. The queens are wondering who's the VIP who has arrived. Krishna made Sudama sit on a high pedestal. He brought a vessel of water and sat down to wash the feet of his friend. This is the sentiment of God towards his friend. And as he lifted the water, he saw the parched feet, the cracked skin, and the little pebble stuck inside. And Karuna Nidhan started doing Karun Krandan. Dekhi Sudama ki Dina Dasha Karuna Karike Karuna Nidhiroe Pani Parat ko Hath Chue Nahi Nainan ke jal sopad dhoe. Krishna now, he had put his water mug there to wash, but he started washing his friend's feet with the tears from his eyes. This is Sakya Bhav. And even higher is Vatsalya Bhav. Mother Yashoda does not in the world think that my Lala is God. Hence she tells her sakhis, Vishnur Nityam Upasate Sakhimaya Tena Trinita Kshanam Shanke Putanika Dayakshitiruhau Tau Vatyayon Mulitau. O sakhis, I worship Narayan. And you all also worship Narayan. It is by the grace of Narayan that my child was saved from Putana. It is beyond his capacity. So Yashoda thinks she is responsible to reform Krishna. Once Krishna was not listening, and Yashoda, she took Krishna and put him into a room and locked the room from the outside. So the way it unfolded was like this. Krishna, tvam pathakim pathami nanure, shastram kimugyayate, tatvam kasya vibho sakastribhuvana dhishaschatena pikem. Yashoda said, Lala, tvam patha, you study. Krishna thought, study? Till today I have been doing so many wonderful things. Now Maya says, study. What should I study, Maya? So Maya is not like the parents of Kalyug, who wants that her child should become doctor, engineer, and then later on mistreat the parents to any extent. So Yashoda is very vidushi wise. She says, Lala, you study Shastra, scripture. Sri Krishna said, scripture? What will I get from scripture, Maya? Yashoda said, Lala, tatvam, you will get tatva gyan. Maya, tatva gyan about what? Vibho, about God. Krishna, God is saying, who is this God? Tribhuvanapati, he is the master of the three worlds. Are Maya, if I get knowledge about Tribhuvanapati, then what will happen? Lala, you are asking, tatvam jnanam bhakti ratho virakti ranaya kim mukti revastute. You will get jnan, you will get vairagya, you will get bhakti, and finally your mukti will happen. Sri Krishna said, mukti? Are Maya, I don't want any mukti fukti. I am feeling hungry, you give me butter and roti, I will be happy. So now Maya said, if you are not willing to study, she took him and put him into the cellar. But Maya is such a simpleton, she put him in the same cellar where she used to put the butter. So butter thief finds that he is this butter here. He realized, immediately went and started eating it. Now Yashoda remembered, oh my God, what is it that I did? She came running. She opened the door and said, Are mere baap. You know, when the mother is annoyed, she addresses the child also like this. What were you doing? So Sri Krishna involuntarily blurted out, Mother, I was doing nothing. Nothing? Then on your hands, what is this white on your hands? Now Krishna realized he had been eating butter, his hands were smeared. He said, oh mother, looking at this, are you doubting by any chance that I was eating butter? Of course. No. You see, you have put these ornaments on me, Padmanag, etc. They were generating heat. So I was cooling my hands by putting it in the butter. Yashoda said, really? Arey Lala, I'm growing old, I don't understand things easily. Now I understand, you were cooling your hand like this. But tell me, what ornament was on your face? Because he had been eating, so his face was also smeared. Krishna realized there's another problem. He said, Maya, by any chance, are you doubting, looking at this, that I was eating butter? No. You see, these curly hair of mine, they were repeatedly coming in front. Now I am a little, I don't have the intellect to first remove the butter and then put the hair back. I was doing like this, it might have stuck somewhere. Mother thinks, my Lala is so expert in making up things right now, when he grows up, what will happen? This is the ras that the Lord bestows on the devotee. And this ras is available to all of us. And even higher is Madhurya Bhav. This is the Bhav of the gopis. He is my soul beloved. Parikshit asked Shukadev in the Bhagavat, Brahmano paro bhavet Krishna hayan prema katham bhavet. Every mother loves her child. And these gopis are going to see the child of Yashoda. How did this happen? Shukadev said, Krishna me nama vehitva matma namakhilatmana. Look, Parikshit. This Krishna is the soul of all souls. This is the body. We are the soul. Our soul is the body of God. And he is the soul of all the souls. So he is our soul beloved. So can I look on Krishna as my soul beloved? Krishna says the delay is not from my side. Delay is in your own intellect. All you need to do is to shed these distances and see me as your all in all. So this treasure chest of love, which he brought with him and revealed in his sweet divine pastimes, became available to us souls who came after him in this age of Kali. And the scriptures and the saints, they explain to us, look how easy it is to love God. You have seen, you have considered your father, mother, spouse, children as yours. Now make a resolve. Krishna eva mama swami. Krishna eva sakha mama. Krishna eva suta priyan. Shri Krishna sevyate maya. But you will only succeed if you decide that Krishna's birth was divine, his form is divine, and his leelas are also divine. Then, without doubt, you will go forth cultivating the devotional sentiments. How merciful he is. How causelessly graceful he is. How all attractive his form is. And these sentiments are the ones that will nurture your bhakti and lift you up from this ocean of life and death to the supreme divinity, the ultimate destination of God realization. This is the purpose of the Lord's descension and the secret of his avatar. Bolie Krishna Kanhaiya Lal Ki. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Bolie Shri Radha Krishna Bhagwan Ki Jai. Siyavara Ram Chandra Ki Jai. Jai Jai Shri Radhe. Jai Jai Shri Radhe. Jai Jai Shri Radhe.